In a previous video, we accessed the NASA API to fetch URLs of images from Mars. In this video, we'll display that and wrap up the Mars Rover Photography flow. Let's get started. First of all, I'm going to create a new node and we'll call it BackDomain. This is just to keep redirection logic outside of the DisplayImage node. Now we'll go back to the DisplayImage node and create an action. To display an image, we are going to have the action say something, but this time we won't be picking text as the content. We'll select Image and create a new image. You can see here there are two ways to pick an image, with file upload and with URL. We'll pick URL because we'll use the one received from using the NASA API. On the right of the input, you can see an Insert Variable button. That lets us know we can have dynamic content here. If we click it, it injects the variable braces and shows us the available variable. But we're not going to use that. The image content has an added layer of protection and escapes variables by default. We need to use triple braces instead of the normal two to avoid escaping. Now we can write temp.roverImageURL and close the braces. Make sure the variable name is in camel case. For the title, we'll write image from Curiosity Mars Rover. Submit and whoops! I forgot to confirm the image URL by clicking OK. Let me do that right now. Alright, now it works. Let's transition display image to back to main always. We'll have back to main say, there you go, cheers from Mars. And like we did in the fallback redirect flow, we'll add a 2-second delay. Finally, we'll transition back to main to the main flow. Just a quick note, we could merge these two nodes, but I like to have each node be responsible for only one thing. If we branched our conversation within the Rover Pictures flow, we could always reuse the back to main node. Let's try it out. Let's type hi, then yes, show me pictures, and March 3rd, 2018. And it displays our image and redirects us back to our main flow, just as it should. So that was how you display images and wrap up your flows. This also wraps up our follow-along tutorial. I really hope you enjoyed it. There are still many things to explore about Botpress, including how to deploy production-ready instances, which we'll cover in later videos. If you have any questions about Botpress, please check out our forum. If you have any questions about the video, please leave them in the comments below.